Last time we had finished with a question on the Monarchia. If you could have a look around, the Monarchia is a volcano situated in the Pacific Ocean, which harbors the largest astronomical observatory in the world. It is in fact over 10,000 meters in height, and therefore it is taller than the Mount Everest. The catch is, 60% of it is underwater. With that, let's start with today's topic. Today we'll be speaking about the Bay of Bengal. Now before I begin, there's a fun fact for you. Did you know that in the coastal state of Odisha, there is a small town where the sea recedes for about 5 kilometers. So in Chandipur, every day the sea goes back for 5 kilometers and then comes back during the high tide. So in effect, during low tide, you can go for a walk on the seabed or even play a little bit of football with your friends before the waters come back during the high tide. Another very fascinating phenomena which takes place in the state of Odisha again and bordering the Bay of Bengal is the onset and coming ashore of the olive ridley turtles. Now these turtles come ashore to lay eggs, and annually it is said that about 8 lakh of them come at one time. This phenomena takes place around March-April, and incidentally, in 2020, it is after 7 years that these turtles have nested in the day. These are just two of the many truly phenomenal places surrounding the Bay of Bengal. Now, the Bay of Bengal is the largest bay in the world, covering an area of about 1,72,000 square kilometers. It is a bay because it is surrounded on three sides by land. On the west, by India, on the north, by Bangladesh, on the east, by Myanmar, and also by the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. There are various important ports along the Bay of Bengal, including Madras, Chennai, Visakhapatnam, Kolkata, and Chittagong, which is in Bangladesh. Crossing over, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands are a union territory of India. They consist of 572 islands, and they are known for their beautiful beaches and pristine waters. They are also known for the cellular jail or the Kalapani, which housed many revolutionaries and freedom fighters of India. During the World War II, from 1942 to 1945, the cellular jail as well as the islands were under the Japanese, and in a dramatic turn of events, many of the jail's inmates were British troops. You may have heard of the various cyclones which hit the countries surrounding the Bay of Bengal, the Indian Ocean, and the Arabian Sea. In 2019 itself, about 7 named cyclones, including the Fani, the Vayu, and the Bulbul, hit these areas. Now, have you ever wondered how are these cyclones named? You will be surprised to know that it does not depend on which country the cyclone hits first or which areas are affected by it. In fact, for the cyclones originating in the Bay of Bengal, in the North Indian Ocean, and also in the Arabian Sea, there are 8 countries which have gotten together, and those countries are Thailand, which is a little to the east, Myanmar, Bangladesh, India, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Pakistan, and Oman. These 8 countries have gotten together and put down 8 names each, and from this list of 64 names, each time a cyclone originates in this area, it is given a name. In December 2019, 2 cyclones hit these areas, and the last 2 names of the list were given to them. Can you find out which 2 countries gave the names for those 2 cyclones? I hope to see you again very soon.